Best of the best, the best of.
Why, hello there.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Game Grumps.
Aaron, what game is this?
It's called Yume Nikki.
Well, she eats with chopsticks and a spoon, so she is very multicultural.
What the hell? They have spoons in Japan, dude.
I don't know, man. I'm just trying to make conversation. And her fucking clock has no hands, so that's weird.
She uses chopsticks and a spoon. How else are they supposed to eat soup, Dan?
Very quickly with chopsticks.
Soup's a huge...
All right, let's do it. I have no idea what this game is.
Me neither.
Okay.
Here we go.
Hey, I'm Grump. I'm not so Grump.
Give them back, Brendan.
No.
Give us the Game Grumps, Brendan. Daddy needs the Game Grumps, Brendan.
Hey! Hello.
It's Game Grumps.
It's Game Grumps. How are you doing, Aaron?
I'm good right now.
Cool.
I really hope that I could keep that up, but...
Me too.
No! That's a pawn!
Tis.
Ooh. Chick. Oh, we can't go there. What the fuck? No, what the hell was I thinking?
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm such an ass.
Chick. How's that taste? That'd be a
hell
terrible
you.
Move anyway.
Shut up.
Hey, what are you doing?
I was trying.
Okay, sorry.
Gosh. No. Near. Far. I don't know what to do at this point.
You just gotta do something.
I know I gotta do something, but I don't know what to do.
We're just not gonna use
them. We got it, done.
We're not gonna use them otherwise. They're just gonna sit there.
I know!
Oh, crap. Wish I had a thing.
You would have... Fuck! You would have had a thing for like 3 seconds, and then you would have gotten another thing.
Can we be penguins?
Let's be penguins.
Okay, yay!
All right. You've convinced me.
Yeah! All right,
how
baby.
How fucking silly we are.
I love it.
Let's go!
I love it that our penguin bodies matched the color of our different jeans that we wear. Like, mine is a slightly darker, more cobalt blue.
Yeah. Hey, Mario. Oh, shit.
No!
Ah!
Oh, my gosh. Well then.
Mario, what's your Uber rating?
5!
Oh, mine's 4.2.
I threw up in the back of a car once.
It was not my fault. He was driving all swervy and curvy.
Swervy and curvy.
I love how Jory's so tickled by when I say, hell yeah.
Yeah, he does love it.
Please don't die. I'm coming. Oh, yes.
Boy, I don't want to toot my own horn.
Yeah.
But I really came through aces on that one.
You did.
I just fucking, no, I just buckled down and I was amazing. I'm just kidding.
It's true, though. He did really well.
Oh, thank you.
I mean... I'm trying to spin it into a joke, but it's just inappropriate.
What? You can say it.
It's just you, me, and a
couple hundred thousand.
I said, please don't die. I'm coming.
Yeah, I got what you're saying. Like, when you're fucking someone who's almost dead and, like, you just want them to hang in there until you nut. We've all been there, dude.
That's exactly what... Please don't die.
Baby. Seriously, I need you to, like, really not die right now.
I'm trying so hard. I really want to be there for you on this one. But... Oh!
Oh, great. Well, now I guess I'm a necrophiliac. But as long as I'm here...
Well, he wouldn't be a necrophiliac if he didn't enjoy it. It's like the moment she was dead, he was like, "Ew!" And then everything would...
Then you're in the clear.
Yeah.
Still probably nut, though. Should we be talking about...
No.
Should we edit this?
No, that's awful.
Okay.
It's terrible.
I'm just saying. Listen. Who amongst us But never mind.
This is an innocent joke about somebody who's about to die.
Yeah. Who you happen to be making-
That's why I didn't want to make a joke about it, because it was inappropriate!
Oh my god, that guy's a beast.
Yeah, he's coming for you.
But he's not dead, so I got nothing to worry about.
Alright, back into the depths we go.
Hey Billy, what's your favorite episode of GameGrumps? I've been already talking about fucking a dead person for a long time! Well, thanks, Billy!
Some really good feedback, we're gonna use that. I'm gonna give that to them. Dear GameGrumps. I don't steal my thing.
No, well, that you haven't said it in so long. I feel like it became public domain again.
It's true.
I did it! Oh, dude.
I mean your ass.
Man, I don't know how to tell you this. Mm-hmm. I got a shit, man.
No! You like that, ladies?
I don't like it.
This concludes the first episode of Lady Grumps. All right, I'll pause the episode. Okay. Hey ladies, it's Dan. I haven't paused the episode yet. Aaron's ripping a horrific deuce. How you doing? You having a great day out there? That's nice. I made you some fresh coffee. It's in the pot. Sorry, Matt and Ryan, I'm just cracking myself up here. Hold on, I gotta find the... we still haven't paused the episode. I just have to find the thing that... I gotta push the button for the pausies. Whoops, that's not the right button. Is that it? No, oh, fuck. Okay, we'll be right back after these commercial, shits.
Hi.
Welcome back. Aaron is in distress of the gastrointestinal kind.
Oh man.
Oh, you poor angel.
Not having a good day.
I'm sorry, homie.
It's okay, man. Just gotta go to a doctor.
Yeah,
you know?
Just gotta grind it out like the grinding stone tower. But I have seriously forgotten what it actually stands
for.
It's toast, right? Applesauce.
Yes, it's bananas.
Bananas.
Applesauce, but some people just say apples, which is why I'm eating an apple right now. Rice. And,
toast?
Toast, yeah. We already said toast.
Whoa!
And tea. Tea is...
Oh!
Some people say brat with two T's.
Brattata.
Who
is the person that we just hung out with that, is completely disgusted by bananas?
Disgusted by bananas?
Well... Oh, I'm alive! Fuck!
Was it Ethan?
It might have been Ethan. Who the hell was that? I feel like it was someone on our vacation. Could it have been Stella?
That doesn't like bananas.
Someone was, like, absolutely physically disgusted by bananas.
Yes! I mean... Not the greatest.
I like them. It's something about the taste and texture.
Well, you know, personally, I like eating bananas, like just straight up bananas. But whenever bananas are on something, I fucking hate it.
Interesting.
Because they're just so mushy and like a fresh peeled banana. Like hell yeah, I'll eat the shit out of that. But once it's put on, like, French toast, I'm like, why ruin French toast?
What are you doing?
This is an awful idea! French toast is delicious, it's covered in maple syrup and powdered sugar! Why are you gonna put fucking... I went to a diner the other day.
You monster frisbee. What, yeah?
And I ordered French toast.
Mm-hmm.
And I said to her, I said, can I get that French toast but with no bananas? And she was like, yeah, no problem. And then she was like, do you want me to put strawberries on instead of bananas? And I was like, what do you fucking think? I just hate bananas? No, I don't want fucking fruit on my damn my French toast! Who the fuck wants fruit on their French toast? It's stupid! Fruit is delicious! But if you put it on French toast, what's the fucking point? Ruins it!
Wow, Aaron.
French toast is such a, like a nutty, like...
I had no idea you felt this
way. Like, savory flavor. Like, it's fucking awesome. You don't put, like, tangy ass shit on it. Like, it's disgusting. It ruins everything. I don't understand.
Oh,
it.
How do I get that? Ah, dang
you
it.
You just can't. This happened a long time ago.
Whoa! Oh, dang it.
I almost hesitate to tell this story because it's... I don't want it to be...
Hey, alright.
I don't want it to come off as like a humble brag.
Oh,
or
no.
Brag in general.
Yeah, don't even go humble brag. Just go straight brag.
I was having
Hit me with that dick brag, bro.
I was having a conversation with a friend.
Uh-huh.
And this is a long time ago.
What, like, do you ever get itchy on like the 14th inch of your dick? Like, do you ever have that?
I had a friend. He was just so excited that he was like, I recently found out that I've got a huge dick, man. I've got a huge dick. And I was like, really? He was like, yeah, it's this big. And I was like, cool. He was like, you've probably got a huge dick, right? And I was like, I guess.
Whoa. Oh, no.
And then he was like, how big is yours? And I was like, oh, it's this big. And he was, I could see like the disappointment. I was because it was bigger.
Congratulations.
Because it was bigger.
Right.
And he was like, oh. like all excitement for like, dude, we're like big dick buddies, like yeah. Completely went away.
Well, I mean, it's not just size. You gotta know what you're doing, man.
Ah, that's the problem I have with training right now because I have to.
Oh, sorry.
In order to train like in a healthy way, my body. I mean.
Yes. Oh God, man.
Whoa, there you go.
Well, that is just my brain overloaded. Sorry, continue.
Well, I got back pain in Hawaii. I like I had like a whiplash from snorkeling.
Yeah. Like a slow whiplash.
Yeah. I won't go into that, but that's what I got, and that's how I got it. So I don't want to hear anybody being like, how the fuck did you? That doesn't make sense.
Yeah, you can't do that. I'm a professional snorkelist. That's what I got, and that's how I got it. That's why I don't want to hear any of your shit. Oh, man.
You know exactly what I'm talking about, though.
Yeah, we've just had too many YouTube comments in our lives. Sorry about that. It's not us trying to be like, how dare you try to help. Just Genesis games as a whole were very mysterious to me because I was very much a Nintendo kid. And I only played Genesis when I was over at my friend Josh's.
You were a Nintendo kid? Get in the game.
You fucking piece of shit. I'll still get heated. I'll go right back to like sixth grade on the playground chats. Like, the only thing that got more heated than Nintendo versus Sega was who's the best Ninja Turtle?
Raphael.
Leonardo.
Leonardo.
Yeah, he's the leader of the
group. He's got Nard in his name.
It's not his fault.
Well, it's there to begin with.
I mean, in retrospect, it was mostly because he was blue, and that's my favorite color. But at the time, I was like, he's got the swords that he never uses, and
that is a shame.
Yeah, he would just throw him up into the ceiling and then grab him and then kick people while hanging from them. Oh, wait. Yes!
It's a mysterious figure. This is the first time we've ever seen Shadow.
I see your cock is as big as mine.
Would you show me your cock? I'll show you my cock. Chaos Control! Now your cock is mine. Ah, my cock!
Oh my God! Holy shit, dude! I'm not emotionally prepared for this to go on this adventure.
A Sonic adventure.
I love it. I'm always down.
Ah, where'd he go? My cock!
Yeah.
Now I've got you by your cock. And I steal cocks.
Do you need me to speak up? This music is playing very loudly.
What is he? Well, it looks like you.
Oh my God.
Sweet, sweet girls, so sweet. Wait, you have to talk up. Could you turn down the music? No. Turn it up? No.
Oh my God, they really have a fucking volume problem in this game.
Oh yeah.
She's like trying to talk, and all you can hear is like, Sonic will be there for you!
And this is the re-release.
Oh god, this is like the polished version?
Yes.
Yipes.
They were like, ah, it's fine. You can just slide some fucking sliders around on these levels.
It's like they took it into their boss and just said, listen, we're gonna be really honest with you. We don't care. And the boss was like, yeah, I don't care either.
Oh, we're on the same page then.
Let's go to Fridays.
Let's go to Fridays. And it's Friday.
TGI.
Or just starts fucking high-fiving, and then a montage starts of them, like, eating Fridays.
Yeah, like, drinking, like, the fucking mimosas or whatever they make there.
And then it just divulges into, like, throwing up on each other.
Fridays never looks as good on Saturday.
They get fucking kicked out. Like, they get into a bar fight with some guy, and one of them ends up getting their hand chopped off in
a Vietnamese back alley dice game.
Woo!
And then you see,
we made Sonic.
Yeah. And then you see him at the Sonic release party, and everyone gives him the thumbs up, and he's just like, oh, because he has no hand.
Oh no.
Yeah.
That's so...
But no, he doesn't care. Nothing's gonna keep him down.
Nothing's ever gonna keep him down because he made Sonic.
Yeah. Then you see at his house, he's got a version of the game that, like, you can control the characters with your eyes.
My magnum opus.
So with that, I give you chapter 130 of Sonic's Ultimate Harem. Galaxy Passion.
Looks like somebody's got his cock.
Oh my god. Alright, I hope you're all ready. This begins with a quote, but it won't become clear until... Okay. Sasha encountered you, and you two had sex once again for the second time? Mario inquired. Pretty much, Sonic responded, shaking his head. Man, you sure are a woman magnet, desperately wanting your loving, am I right? Ain't that the truth? Sonic's cell phone vibrates, notifying him that he has a text message. Sonic pulls out his phone and views the message coming from She-Hulk posing sexily for Sonic.
Ooh, hell yeah.
Send Sonic a picture with a smile on her face. She then posted, Sonic, honey, it's She-Hulk. It's been long since we haven't hang out. You have my number. Call me. Also, Sonic has a second message, which it was from Karen Starr, aka Power Girl herself.
Hell yeah, it's getting hot.
She posed a selfie picture posing her large breasts with a smile and also posted, Sonic, did you get my picture? These melons are yours to fondle and play with.
Whoa!
I would love to see you again. Give me a call or a text sometime, honey. I'll be waiting. Sonic just about to put his phone away until he gets another message. When he views the message, it was another picture, as it was from Crimson Viper this time.
Ooh.
She poses herself on the picture, showing her cleavage, puckering her lips in the picture.
Hell yeah.
She even wrote, hey there, handsome. It's been a while since we had sex together. I would like to see you again, and I know you love my tits. Give me a call whenever you're available, and I can give you a nice titty fuck once again.
Whoa,
XOXO.
Oh, man.
Sonic then finally puts his cell phone away, bringing his attention back to Mario. So who is the next girl have you encountered? Mario questioned. Oh, man. How can I put this? You see, I happen to sleep with, sigh, Princess Rosalina.
Ooh.
Mario dropped his jaw in total shock.
That's fucked up.
What? Are you telling me that you... Of course, Mario. I slept with Rosalina. When did this happen? How did you two end up sleeping together? Oh, I forgot to ask, Rosalina is my ex-girlfriend. I think he meant, oh, I forgot to say Rosalina is my ex-girlfriend.
Oh, okay.
What? Damn it, Sonic. What have you been getting yourself into lately from all these females and some ex-girlfriends you have?
Females?
I don't know. I wish I do. Wait, I wish I... Yeah, I don't know. I wish I do. So are you going to tell me the story of how you and Rosalina slept together? Certainly. It was when I came to see you all in a race in the Mario Kart Stadium showing yo all great support. I heard about it, so I've decided to come see you and the others race. flashback.
What?
This is
flashback?
The, yeah. This is, I guess, narration. Sonic in the crowd watching the race watching the race, showing his good friend Mario and the others much support on the race. Sonic was eating some popcorn and having a bottle of soda, watching the race as the race is in its final lap. Mario is in the lead, up ahead from the other racers, trying to get into first place. Wario catch up with Mario, struggling to pass Mario. The two were closing in for the finish on the two were closing in for the finish line on the final lap.
Wait, what the fuck is happening? I completely lost track of what was happening.
This is Mario asked Sonic how he slept with Rosalina. So Sonic is flashing back and painting the picture of how it happened.
I see.
And it happened at the day he went to see the Mario Kart race. And he's watching the race, and Mario and Wario are vying for first position. Are you all caught up?
Ba-ba-da-ba-doo-bop.
Oh my god, she is nightmarish looking in this game.
They left the female behind.
Hashtag lady crimes, hashtag feminism. Elude enemy pursuit. Okay, enough of this fucking trite garbage. Back to what's important.
Yes, please.
Okay. So Sonic just busted into Mario's celebration party. Thank you, Sonic. I'm glad you could come to see the race of the Star Cup. I appreciate it. You invited me, and I heard about the race, so then I decided to come and watch the race. Hey, you know we can race each other sometime. Yeah, I'd like that. Mario smile, and the two shake hands once again. The platinum blonde makes her appearance wearing her bike suit, congratulating Mario on his win.
Hell yeah, she's got that tight bike suit on.
Hello, Mario. Congratulations on your big win, the platinum blonde female princess congratulated. And congratulations, she congratulated.
This can't be sincere.
I think it's dead serious.
Come on.
Dude. No, dude, this is chapter 130. You think he's not committed to this shit? This is his voice, and I'll thank you to fucking respect it.
Oh, I get. Yeah, well, you know what? If it's real, then I like it all the more.
I love Lil Sonic. Where am I? Okay, yes. Thank you, Rosalina, Mario smiled. Rosalina turned her attentions to the blue hedgehog. Oh, hello there. Mario, you never told me you had a wonderful and handsome... You never told me you had a wonderful and a handsome friend here, Rosalina pointed. Oh, I am a sorry, Sonic. This is Princess Rosalina. She helped me save the galaxy and rescue Peach from Bowser, Mario introduced. God, every sentence is an adventure. Hi there, Sonic greeted, extending his hand. Accepts and shake Sonic's hand. It's nice to meet you, Sonic. Are you available? Yeah, I am single, all right, but that doesn't mean I am not ready to mingle.
What?
Wait, that's a double negative. You know what he meant.
Right.
Giggle, that's funny. It sure is.
How nice. Does Mario not remember this?
I don't. It's very.
It was happening right before his eyes.
All of a sudden.
Wait, you're telling me you fucked Rosalina?
Yeah. After you.
That's out of nowhere.
After you flirted like crazy. All of a sudden, Princess Peach in her bike suit appears and kisses Mario on the cheek. Congratulations, Mario, and oh hi there, Sonic. I'm glad that you can come to the party. Peach smiled. You're welcome. I couldn't miss it for the world. Sonic shrugged. It's good to see you here, Sonic. You too, Peach. Who is talking? Did you see the race? Yes, I did. And you even looking hot in your biker suit, Peach. Thank you, Sonic.
That's appropriate, Sonic.
Anyway, Sonic, can I burrow you for the moment? sure, letter S. It's something important? Yes, it is. Mario, I'll spend time with you a little later. I need to talk to Sonic in private.
Oh, yeah, does she?
Oh, sure thing, Peach. Thank you.
Is this whole fucking thing just Sonic cucking Mario?
Just fucking listen. We're getting there.
Okay.
Thank you. Come in, Sonic. Princess Peach takes Sonic's hand and leads him away from the party. It was nice meeting you, Rosalina, Sonic stated. Yeah, I'll side piece you later. Rosalina smiled at Sonic, and Mario notices it. That Sonic character sure is very handsome, Rosalina commented. I wonder what Peach wanted to talk to Sonic about, Mario wondered. probably something important. Do you know what it is, Mario? I wish I knew, but probably some business. That's my guess.
Meanwhile,
in Peach's bedroom, Sonic sat down on a bed, softly moaning. He was getting pleasured by Princess Peach as she is down on her knees and sucking off Sonic by giving Sonic a blowjob. Her suit was even unzipped, showing her cleavage off with a pink lace bra on as she looked down, sucking off Sonic's shaft, hard and deep, slurping and licking it onto it, earning the moans from Sonic.
That's why I want my cock back!
Sonic watch in a... Sonic watch.
Do you understand now?
Sonic watch in amusement with a smile on his face while he lets out some soft moans from Peach's blowjob.
Hell yeah.
Peach start deep throating Sonic, letting his shaft sit in her throat for seconds, having Sonic moan some more before pulling herself away from his shaft before sucking it back in.
Yeah,
ah!
Dude.
Sonic moaned, licks Sonic's shaft and strokes it. You like it, baby? Peach asked, pleasing Sonic. Yes, but you and Mario are in a relationship. I don't want to have sex with you again, Sonic countered. Oh no, we're not going to have sex, so you don't have to worry about that. All I am just giving you a blowjob, and that's all. Sound fair. I guess that makes sense.
Yeah, that's totally not sex.
Good. Now sit back and relax, handsome. Sonic decide, watching Peach sucking him off hard and deep as this continue on for several minutes.
Why do they have to fucking refer to him as the hedgehog?
Would you shut up? This is fucking hot. You're killing the mood.
I'm sorry.
There's a rhythm to this. Peach began licking the head of Sonic's shaft and stroking faster and harder, twirling her tongue on the head of Sonic's shaft, making him shiver down his spine and strokes off his shaft. As this continue on, then finally Sonic start to ejaculate himself as he bursts and spreading his seed on Peach's face and her breasts, giving out a huge amount of his seed. That's not the way I expected that sentence to wrap up. Peach wiped...
That was a huge amount.
...of my seed. Peach wiped the cum and licks it with her fingers sexily. Afterward, she deliver a smile on her face and strokes off Sonic's shaft some more. Did you enjoy it, Sonic? Peach asked. To be honest, yes I did, Sonic answered.
Yep.
Is that a ninja rustling in the bushes? Yeah.
I think they were talking shit about you.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, he saw me.
Did he?
Yeah. I'm gonna eavesdrop.
I don't know. Maybe there's just dramatic music for no reason.
Yeah, he saw me. He's coming at me.
Yeah, shit.
Look at me. Oh, what did you say?
Like, you'd think you'd hear that music.
I feel like a master samurai is coming after me right now, but... I guess I'll learn about Lord Genichiro.
I'll let this play out. Oh no!
No, it's fine.
I'm just kidding.
That's never happened.
Happened 1,000 times.
Yeah.
What a beautiful looking game.
Yeah. Is he coming after me? Is he like...
No! No, I think you're alright. That was amazing timing, Aaron.
Found him! Yeah, he's dead.
Yeah. It just gives you helpful tips, like,
don't die.
Once discovered, you can go ahead and abandon stealth mode.
When discovered.
Just start running.
Run the fuck away.
Okay.
And keep running. Rings.
Oh, thank goodness.
Yeah, throw that fire.
Ah!
Fuck.
Okay, cool. I always think of Brent Weinbach when he joined us, and like, you were close to dying playing Time Lord, and he was like, be careful, please be careful. Like, just so genuine. I always think about it. Oh god!
I fucking miss that guy, man.
Me too. We should
treat.
We should give him a ring.
That guy fucking rules.
He's a very cool dude.
I've been thinking about his Russian alphabet lately.
Oh. God, we used to say that shit all the time.
I know, and people would be like, what the fuck is that Hai Chi Kao thing they say?
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe just the most amazing and hilarious thing you've ever heard.
Yeah, what about that?
That's probably what it is. Oh, oh, where'd he go? Oh, okay.
He's juking me! You see how he's juking?
Oh,
that the fucking camera's not helping!
You missed Doug. Oh, careful,
TikTok! You juke him!
Yeah!
Now you gotta hit him.
No! Oh, fuck this! I'm so...
It, that was a definite, like, little juke move he gave you. Oh, God!
No, he can't get me! Whew. If I tell him to go away, he will! That's the ghost rule!
Boy, that thing has to be... Where's the hourglass? Nice.
I'll just keep an eye on this dickbag.
Would you like that sous vide?
I'm sorry?
No, can I get a poignon?
Ah.
Yes, absolutely. Salt?
Would you like to see my nipples?
I love this. Well, first of all, I'm sorry I cut you off there, because it looked like you were onto something. Secondly, I love this background. God damn it.
Oh, God!
Drown! You stupid fuck!
Have a great day, everyone.
Yeah.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Next time on Grumpity Goos.
Same time, same place.
Same grump time, same grump place.
Oh, what? Oh, look at the little guy just flopping around there with his little body.
Scoobity-scoobity-scoobity!
Yeah.
We'll see you later, babies.
Oh no, Wiggler.
My dad was a Wiggler.
What does that mean?
It's whatever you want it to mean.
Oh, goodness gracious,
man. I do not
man.
Have the patience anymore to explain my non-jokes to you.
I was listening back to Matt's rap song about having sex with his dad.
Yeah.
I cannot handle how funny that shit is.
It's pretty hilarious.
Ooh, I'm in love with my dad. Sucking my dad's toes and grabbing his sack. Yeah. It's like the super confident, yeah, hell yeah. You fucking love this shit.
Well, next time on Game Grumps.
Oh, geez, is it time already?
Yeah.
Oh, gosh, alright.
We're gonna go to Iggy's Volcanic Castle.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
That'll be fun.
Sucking my dad's toes and
grabbing his sack. Oh. Yeah. Go listen to that. Apparently.
Where do you listen to it?
I don't know. It's gotta be out there. Just look up Matt Watson's dad.
It's at the end of one of his podcasts.
Fucking his dad song.
Because Ryan just, like, at the end of the podcast, he's like, well, how's your dad? And then it just, that starts. He's like, ooh.
Well, someone definitely uploaded it.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty great. Proud of you, Matt.
Thank you, Dan.
Oh, I love you.
Goodbye, then. Bye.
Supermega.com. Supermegaofficial.com. Supermega. YouTube.com/supermegashow.
Matt Watson at clownpenis.fart. Bye.
I want to get a clownpenis.fart email. Just give it to, like, banks and shit.
Desperately. Desperately want that.
And what's your email? That's Aaron at clownpenis.fart.
To shoot the fat means to talk to someone at length, or maybe just chat with someone, but it must be the idea, like, after you finish the meat in the meal, like, there's just a fat left, but you want to hang out and talk more.
Oh. So
I guess that's where it comes from? I don't know, for sure.
Damn. It's a good steak.
Yeah. Welcome to our linguistics podcast. Do you all like it?
That's a podcast format. We were talking about podcast formats before we started the episode.
Yeah. Brian loves those.
Yeah, that's definitely a podcast format that exists.
It is weird, right? There's multiple ones.
I feel like there's a lot of pressure for a linguistics podcast. Because if you, like, fuck up just talking...
Yeah.
And people are like, well, why did you even watch this in the first place? You stupid idiots. You don't even know. Anyway, next time.
Kind of like doing a Let's Play channel where neither guy can play video games well.
Well, that's beside the point.
Yeah, I'm just saying. Goodbye.
Bye. We should just call it a Let's Joke.
Yeah. A Let's Jerk. Oh, my God.
Oh.
Think of all the time we could save if we got our jacking off and Let's Playing out of the way at the same time. Come on.